I'm getting dumber as this unboxing goes further on. Hey guys, this is Austin, and this is a phone. Or is it a computer? Or is it both? So this is the HP Elite X3. If you guys saw my cool phones of 2016 video I did, this is one of the phones I was really excited to check out. However, it is taking a long time to actually go on sale. This might be the biggest phone box of all time. Actually, why is this so big? So this is a Windows 10 phone. However, instead of just being an ordinary Windows phone, so first of all, we have the actual HP Elite X3 itself. And as you can see, this is a very big phone. We also have the dock, which is really heavy. What? So this is a USB-C dock. So what you do is you drop your phone on this guy. So around back, we have USB Type-C, a couple of USB 3 ports, a full-size display port, and Ethernet. The idea is that this is a phone that you take around all day. Of course, it does all the normal phone things. When you get home, you drop it on the dock and it essentially replaces your computer. So something interesting is, in addition to this dock, there's also an option that is essentially turns this phone into a laptop. They're actually doing some really cool stuff here, which is interesting given that Windows Phone is maybe not the most popular that's ever been. So fair warning on this guy, it does not come cheap. Although it does come with some very stylish earbuds. Now, continuing on, because I've got to imagine there's... Yeah, there's a couple things left. A pile of paperwork on the dock, which apparently they gave me two of everything in case I was unsure of how to use a dock. What else is in here? So we have a dock for the dock? Oh, why? These are the exact same, except one has a larger cutout. How dare you? There's another one! Wait, but this looks the same! Oh, wait, it says on the inside. So this is for the phone. This is for the phone with a case, and this is for the phone with a flip cover case. I totally didn't need to read the instructions to find that out. And we also have a mysterious black box here. I swear, if this is gonna be another adapter for the stupid dock. It's another adapter. Now it's time for the real test. Does this crazy dock actually work? So right now I have it plugged in, so it's powering the phone. However, I wanna actually see what we can do here. So first of all, we have a keyboard. I'll plug this right into the back of it. Also have a mouse. Actually, I'm curious, can I use keyboard and mouse without anything else? Oh, I have a cursor. All right, I gotta admit, that's kind of cool. The scroll wheel works. Open up Edge. This is the world's weirdest desktop ever. So everything's plugged into the dock. Now if I drop the phone on, do I see a welcome screen? I don't know, do I? Hello. All right, so now my mouse is on the display. Okay, so now if I want, the phone is a touchpad. So even though this is a Windows 10 device, it does not actually run full Windows 10. It's still running the phone edition. So not all apps are going to work. So we've got the full desktop version of YouTube. Can we actually watch a video like this? Yeah, there we go. You know, it almost feels like I'm using like a Chromebook or something. It's a little bit slower than like a proper computer, but it works. I mean, scrolling is fairly smooth. There's maybe a touch of latency, but really, I mean, for normal sort of like web browsing, it seems to be fine. Let's see what else we can do here. So even though this is not a full Windows 10 device, you can still do some cool stuff. Hey guys, this is Austin. That totally works. I can actually see something like Word being a really solid use of this, right? So if you don't want to travel with a lot of extra gear, and while the apps are not quite as, well, full-featured as I would like, I mean, we still have basic stuff like web browsing and we can go through and alt tab. And the idea of using one device to do everything in your life is really cool. I see a lot of potential in something like this in a few years as things get more and more polished. But for today, it's not quite there. Don't judge me.